Good morning. We can't get out of that rainy period this time of year.
That's the way it goes. But more rain than normal, too, is coming our way on top of that.
And, you know, Melbourne is getting close to the all-time wettest July they've had. So we do have plenty of rainfall in our forecast right through the middle of the week, guys. You said it. Right now, in fact, on Viper Plus, you can see that we're dealing with some showers really coming in along our west coast here already, right around Rainbow Springs. Had a little rainfall. It's moving northeastward and kind of collapsing. But Sumter County looks like right around Rutland there. You're going to have to watch out for a few downpours heading your way. All right, let's take a look as we walk over here for the rest of the story. This is what's going on. We've got this low-level circulation trying to develop here over the Gulf, and as I put this into motion, you'll see what I'm talking about here. These showers trying to head off to the north and east, and there's just this area of counterclockwise flow out there, surface low trying to develop. That's the story over the next couple of days, and that could hang around out there. That's going to help keep our rain chances on the higher side of average as we go on through the next few days, combined with a front off to our north. So plenty to talk about. We've also got that tropical update coming up. Right now, though, as you head on out, we're in the low to mid-70s right around Kissimmee and OIA with a few warmer readings elsewhere. High temperatures today. We got a west-southwest wind, so even the coast heats on up with this offshore flow right around 92, Daytona Beach down to Melbourne. Palm Coast about 90, as well as Ocala, 91 around Orlando. Just shy of average, I think, with the onset of those showers and storms possibly as early as late morning as that line begins to move right across Orlando into the early afternoon. Now, tracking the tropics, we have our next wave coming off of West Africa there, our next tropical wave getting going. Also, back toward Bermuda, we're watching a disturbance a couple of hundred miles west of Bermuda, and the good news is with this one, if it does develop, it's going to be heading off to the north and east, really in between Bermuda and our eastern coast. So all the models agree that this will not be a land threat, even though it could be moving into a more favorable environment over the next couple of days. We could have Chantal, tropical storm, on our hands in the next day or so, but it does look like it'll stay out over open water and just be a shipping concern. Some heavy rain for Bermuda, but nothing that they can't handle. We take a look at the map now. Here's a stationary front off to our north. Eerily similar to what we saw last week. There's still a big dip in the jet across the eastern coast, so that is keeping our forecast somewhat unsettled. Here's that west coast sea breeze. That comes in today. We get the showers and storms to blow up along that, and they drift off to the east, so even the coast starts to wrap up into the evening hours. Then tomorrow, another round of rainfall in our forecast. There's a low back toward Alabama. I'm watching possible low pressure development right here off the coast of Tampa, so again, unsettled weather in the forecast, 60% today, 70% tomorrow through Wednesday. Thursday, we take the rain chances back to 60, and then Friday through the weekend, a drying and heating trend does look to be in the offing. We could have some mid-90s back then, Danny, so we'll get ready for that.